This video is sponsored by Altium. More on that later.
Hey guys, I'm gonna show you how to run YOLO V7 post estimation on your PC. So let's get started. So first thing you need to do is to head over to store.augmentedstartups.com, and here you'll find a wide variety of projects from gun detection, automatic license plate recognition, lane detection, so much more projects, and you'll really enjoy the amount of free content that we have on the store. So definitely check this out. So what you need to do is to scroll all the way to the bottom, and you'll find the YOLO V7 nano course right over here. So click on get project and you'll be greeted with a screen. You can sign up for free. As I mentioned, you can see all of the lectures that we have on YOLO V7, as well as training your own custom YOLO V7 model. And then right over here at the bottom, we have YOLO V7 pose estimation, and that is the one that you want to check out. Cool, so once you have signed up, you'll be greeted with a screen like this, and you'll be able to access all of the lectures from the Nano course. Now just note that if you don't already have YOLO V7 installed on your PC, you can head over to lecture 1.3, where you can install YOLO V7 on Ubuntu, and then we have lectures 1.4, where you can install YOLO V7 on Windows 10 or 11. Now, this tutorial will work on GPU and CPU. Obviously, you'll get better performance on GPU, but in order for it to work on a GPU, you would need an NVIDIA CUDA-supported graphics card. However, if you don't have a graphics card and you want real-time performance, you can always try it out in Google Colab, which is free. Cool, so before you run this tutorial, make sure that you run YOLO V7 on Ubuntu or Windows 10 or 11, and then we can continue by going over to this lecture, which is lecture 3.1, how to install YOLO V7 post estimation. By the way, if you ever wanted to implement computer vision on a Jetson Nano, but can't really find one, maybe it's due to the chip shortage or something like that. Well, I've got great news for you, because there's a company called Octopart where you can find Jetson Nanos and Raspberry Pis amongst many edge AI hardware. Octopart is like the Google for electronics parts, but integrates seamlessly into Altium. And this allows you to design custom printed circuit boards. So if you are into designing custom hardware for your computer vision enabled cameras, then Altium Designer is the most reliable software for your company or project. You can get access to a free 15-day trial of Altium Designer and access Octopart in the links down below. Cool, so step one is you need to first git clone this repository over here, right? I've already done that and I've downloaded all of the files. It's right over here. Otherwise, you can download all of the files right here. You just click this button and it'll download all of the files. Now, the difference between git cloning it over here versus downloading it over here is that we include the YOLO V7 pose weights, which will allow you to skip step number four, which is this one, right? So you can click over here or git clone it from this repo over here into your terminal. You can do it over here, but because I already have all of the files, I'm going to skip the step. Cool. Step two, we are going to create a new Conda environment from the environment.yml file. This will save you a lot of time and a lot of hassle, because when we installed it via pip, a lot of libraries didn't get installed, which was really frustrating. So this will help you out. So let's go back into our terminal and we're going to say conda env create-f environment.yml. Now, in order for this to work, you first need to ensure that you have cd'd or change directory into the relevant one. So before we run that, we are going to first go and copy our directory and say cd is in change directory to this one, right? And then we're going to go back here and then say copy paste conda create env dash create environment.yml, and that is this file over here. So if you open up this, you'll see all of the dependencies that are required for us to run YOLO V7 pose estimation. So as you can see, there's a cuck lot of dependencies right over here. So let's just give it a minute or two, and then we should have our dependencies installed in just a bit. Great, so YOLO V7 pose estimation has been installed, or at least our dependencies. So what we're going to do is to say conda activate YOLO V7 pose. Right, it works just like that. Cool, so we have conquered this one already, right? So we don't need to do that, and we need to make sure that we have navigate it into our pose estimation folder, which we have already done. The next thing to do is to download these weights from the original Wonking U repository for Yolo V7. Now just note that this is the official Yolo V7 repository by Wonking U. And I'm saying this is because there was another Yolo V7 repository, but that is not the official one. Cool, so if you have done this step where you get cloned the repository, you can click this link here to download our Yolo V7 pose estimation weights. Once it is downloaded, what you're going to do is you're going to copy and paste it right over here. So I already have it in this folder, so I'm not going to copy and paste it back again. Now, as I mentioned before, you can skip step 4 if you have downloaded our pose estimation repo from this link over here. Great. Now we can move on to step 5, where we can run pose estimation. I'm sure you're pretty excited and it seems pretty easy. I don't know about you. So now comes the exciting part where we can run Yolo V7 pose estimation. So we're going to do that by typing python run underscore pose dot py. And we're going to type in dash dash source as 0, which is our webcam. Let me just open my webcam. If you don't already have your webcam connected to your computer, make sure you have that ready. So this will run either on GPU or CPU, depending on which one is your default. So let's see if we know which one it is running on. Let's see if we can tell. Cool. So as you can see, it is running really, really slow. So if you answered CPU, then you would be correct. So this is quite painful for me. So I'm just going to cancel this and run it on GPU. So in order to get that to run, we're going to say dash dash device, and we're going to specify it as 0. So you can either write it as GPU or CPU, whether you want to run it on CPU, but we're going to run it on a GPU, which is device 0. If you have multiple GPUs, then you can specify GPU 1, GPU 2, and so on and so forth. But I only have one GPU, like most of us, so I'm just going to specify it as 0, and then we're going to run it just like that. Let's see what happens. Cool, so as you can see, it works really, really well. If I move back, you probably won't hear me in the mic, but I'm just going to do a quick demo so you can see. So you can see it's picking up quite well. Everything looks fine. And pull some of my moves. That was quite exhausting, but fun nonetheless. So I guess there you have it, guys. We have pose estimation with Yolo V7 running real time on my GPU. It's running on Windows. If you can run on Windows, you can run on anything. I hope so. Cool. So if you want to learn more about Yolo V7, there will be a link down below where you can enroll in the free Nano course if you haven't already enrolled. Also check out Yolo Plus, which is our all-in-one Yolo bundle, which will have Yolo V3, V4, V5, Yolo X, Yolo R, Yolo V7, all in one course. And eventually when Yolo V8, V9, V10, V100, whatever gets released, we will be there to cover it right away. So you don't have to waste time. We are going to be covering everything that you need to know about Yolo and building end-to-end full stack applications for computer vision using Yolo V7 and beyond. So you definitely want to check that out in the links down below.